And what you see today, it's hard to imagine what it looks like. So I'm just going to hand this around and you have a look of what it actually was before 1977. All right? In 1977, we finally did major redevelopment of this whole entire area, including cleaning of that river. From what you see in the picture to what it is today, it took 10 years. Now that is a quick, very short period of time for 10 years to clean such a river to what you see today. And it was under, of course, the idea of our first Prime Minister, Lee Kuan Yew. Okay, he told his ministers, you just have to clean up the river, and I'm giving you only 10 years to do the job. Finish it in 10 years. That's it. Of course, his ministers was, oh, 10 years. Panicked. It was not an easy task. It was not only just cleaning of the river, and they had very few people doing that job, and they were handpicking the rubbish most of the time, diving into the river to retrieve a lot of the rubbish. All right, they also had to relocate the boats, relocate the people, relocate the businesses, all right, to other areas so that they can properly clean it up and redevelop it into what we see today. Restaurants, bars, entertainment, financial district area, which originally was financial district area that Raffles have already designated. Okay, now from this picture here, okay, looking at the river, all right, what kind of animal do you think the river resembles?
A snake.
Whale.
A snake.
Whale.
A whale. Think of something, you know, prosperous. What animal do you think would bring good luck?
Perp.
Sorry?
Just don't say it was a lion.
Don't say it look anything like a lion. All right. To many businessmen around this area, they like to set up over here is because the river resembles a cup. Prosperous cup, which is like the Japanese koi. Okay, can you see it? Okay, well, I'll just point out to you. The bridge over there, that's Elgin Bridge, that's where the tail is. Kavanaugh Bridge heading out is supposed to be where the head is. Can you see it now? No? Okay. Alright, let's see if I can help with that. Okay. Fish. Okay, the prosperous cup. Right here. Okay, alright. Okay. Now, which is the most prosperous part of this fish? Where do you think is most... The belly. Very good. So as you can see the shape of the river here, that is the belly of the cup. And that is known to be the most prosperous place. But something happened. In 1985, Singapore faced recession, and so businessmen and the government consulted masters of feng shui, all right, to find out what's happening. We have so many years of prosperity, and why suddenly now this happened? So the masters came around and had a look and said, well, the belly of the cup is being pierced. That's why you're facing recession. What has pierced the belly of the cup? Look around, what do you think? What could have done that? Any ideas? Buildings, there are so many tall skyscrapers. Could have been the buildings, but the master's one she said no. Think of something underground.
So, piping,
subway.
Yes, our train system. The tunnels that we have to build for our MRT. It's located underground. And if you look at that building just behind the tree, the very low triangular roof building, that is the station for Raffles Place. And then if you look in the distance, you see that circular hotel building, that is the station of City Hall. And the tunnel goes all the way underneath, and it has pierced the belly of the cup. Okay, so of course, they need to think of a solution. it won't be possible to stop the constructions of the tunnel or reroute the tunnel because it was already in process. So the master's feng shui said that there is another solution. All you need to do is to make everyone carry this that will bring good luck to Singapore. So what it is that all of us actually carry? What do you think the most common thing? Very good, money, right. So, let me show you. Some people told me mobile phone. Phones? Not everyone has mobile phone. Okay, so money. This is the money. Look at it. That's the old and that's the new. Should have enough for everybody. I've got lots. Yeah, you can all have a good look at it. Here you go. So many Singaporeans actually don't realize that this design has something to do with feng shui. Yeah. Alright, so if you look at the coin, what do you think is a symbol or design that has something to do with feng shui?
Bangwa?
Lionfish. Lionfish? Oh, Malayan, alright. Yeah, nope, not the Malayan.
It's the outline?
The outline, very good. If you look at the outline, yeah, on the inside of the coin, notice the eight-sided
octagon.
Right. Yeah.
This one, yeah?
Now, feng shui masters use a device known as Ba Gua. Yeah, right, and it has eight sides. Yeah. And that device is not only to analyze where the position of the luck is, but also to be used to remove bad luck. So this is why it's incorporated in the design of this coin. Okay, so if you want good luck all the time, keep a Singapore coin with you. Alright, in your pocket.
Noted.
You will notice that in many retail business, they like to stick this coin on their cash register or their calculator. More money. Come in. Okay, now please give my money back to me.
Thank you.
Thank you. Oh. I can exchange.
Yeah.
There are two different designs. I'm not sure you noticed this. This is the first design that was produced, all right, in 1986 or 87. So then this was a new design. Right, so the new design is so that they probably want to continue and strengthen the luck itself, so no one wants to be responsible for another recession.
These ones don't have
they made another one, different design.
20 cents right? And the 50.
Oh, we can
so with this feng shui thing, it is something very widely believed, not only just by the Chinese, but many businessmen. Right?
Maybe.
Some people think feng shui is religion. No, it's not. It's just a matter of balancing certain elements to make the area more positive, remove the negatives, and that's simple enough. It doesn't even have to be objects. It can just simply be color or shape, okay? So depends on whatever you do to just make the environment comfortable for oneself. That is most important, all right? And these feng shui directions are so important that people not only have it inside their homes or inside their office, it is incorporated into design of buildings. Okay, step over this way. Consulting, I can give you very simple advice, but not too complicated ones. Okay, this one.